What's the buzz about bee business? Business? Although they're tiny, these insects play a huge role in the health of our planet. From pollinating plants to making honey, they do it all without even realizing how much we depend on them. So let's take a peek inside the hive and discover why these little creatures are so important to our world. Want a souvenir of our journey? Check out our fact-filled activity sheets for sale now in the Socratica Foundation store. Find the links below. Bees are superstar pollinators, helping many of our favorite foods to grow. Pollen is a sticky, dusty powder that comes from the male part of flowering plants. It's like one half of a recipe needed to make seeds. For a new plant to grow, this pollen needs to travel and land on the female part of another flower. When that happens, it's like the flower has everything it needs to start making a new plant. Bees help a lot with this, carrying pollen from one flower to another as they look for nectar. Bees drink nectar, which is a sugary liquid made by flowers. Nectar is more than just a sweet treat for the bees. It gives them the energy they need to fly and do their work. They suck up the nectar using their long tongues that work like straws. Their long tongues, called a proboscis, allows the bees to reach deep into the flower to slurp up the nectar. They store some of this nectar in a special pouch called a honey stomach. Pollination is the actual process of pollen moving from one flower to another. This has to happen for the next generation of plants to grow and make the fruits and vegetables we eat. Did you know about a third of the food we eat depends on these busy bees? From crunchy apples to juicy strawberries to plump tomatoes, we really should thank the bees for the many different kinds of foods on our plates. Bees don't have hands, so how are they carrying all that pollen around? In baskets. Pollen baskets are special parts on a bee's legs that work like little backpacks for carrying pollen. When bees visit flowers, they collect pollen and pack it into these baskets to bring back to their hive. We should mention that bees do eat pollen as well as nectar. The pollen is a good source of protein for the bees. You can see the bees get a little dusty from their work, and some of that pollen falls off as they go from flower to flower. But bees actually need to take quite a bit more pollen back with them to feed the hive. That's why these baskets are so important. So when you see a bee with little yellow or orange balls on its legs, these are the pollen baskets full of pollen it has collected from flowers. That bee has been very busy. Bees would already be amazing for doing the important work of pollination. But that's not all they do. They also make honey and beeswax, which are super useful to us. Honey is made when bees collect sweet nectar from flowers and bring it back home. Back at the hive, bees work together to turn this nectar into honey. It's a bit of a strange process. The bees take the nectar from their honey stomachs and pass it around. They chew up the nectar and spit it back out, partly digested, and then store it in the honeycomb. At this point, the nectar has changed from a complicated flowery extract into simpler sugars. The bees fan their wings to help the extra water evaporate, making the sugary syrup more concentrated. Over time, it matures into honey, which they seal up with wax to store as food for themselves and the developing baby bees. But we love it too. Beeswax, another awesome product from bees, is made by young bees who produce it from special glands in their bodies. This wax is used by bees to build their honeycombs, and it serves as a nursery for the young bees. But people have found many uses for it too, like making candles that smell nice and burn slowly, and even in some cleaning products to help polish furniture and make it shine. Speaking of honeycomb, did you know that bees are secretly mathematicians? Let me explain. Honeycomb has a repeating pattern of shapes called hexagons. Hex meaning six and gon meaning corner or angle. Each hexagon has six sides, making it a perfect shape for bees to build their honeycomb. This design is super smart because hexagons fit together without wasting any space. This makes the honeycomb really strong but light, perfect for housing all the hive's needs. So the bees are also excellent structural engineers. Is there anything they're not great at? Oh, and they're really good at flying. Bees have a unique style of flight because they have two sets of wings, a larger pair in the front and a smaller pair in the back. When bees fly, these wings hook together to form one large surface, helping them lift off and move through the air more efficiently. This special design allows bees to carry heavy loads of pollen and nectar back to their hive, and even gives them the ability to hover in place as they collect nectar from flowers. Bees do make a lot of buzzing noise when they're flying around, but they also have a silent form of communication. They use this special way of talking to each other about where to find the best flowers. It's called the Waggle Dance. When a bee finds a really good patch of flowers full of nectar and pollen, it returns to the hive and performs some fancy moves. This dance isn't just for fun. It's a way to give directions. The bee moves in a figure-eight pattern, waggling its body and changing the angle of its dance based on the position of the sun. This tells the other bees the direction and distance to the flowers. By watching the waggle dance, bees in the hive can figure out exactly where to go to find the best feeding spots. It's like a bee saying, "Hey friends, follow me for some great food," without using any words. Bees are truly the most talented insects we know. Did you know that bees are insects? Here's how you can tell. Like all insects, bees have three main body parts: the head, the thorax, and the abdomen. The head has their eyes and antennae, which they use to smell and navigate, while the thorax is where their six legs and two sets of wings are attached, the larger pair in the front and a smaller pair in the back, making four wings total. Unlike humans and other animals that have a skeleton inside their bodies, bees have an exoskeleton, which is a hard, protective outer layer that supports their body and gives them shape. Here's another special feature bees have that we don't: a stinger. See it there at the base of their abdomen? Not every bee gets one. It's the worker bees and the queen who use this pointy defensive weapon to protect the hive. Want to remember the special details of bees? Get out your colored pencils and markers and capture different insects in our coloring pages. Follow the links below for our activity pages that keep the smart fun going after the video. But we're not finished yet. Here come some more bee facts. Some bees are social creatures, meaning they live together in large groups known as colonies. In these colonies, each bee has a role to play, like laying eggs, collecting food, making honey, or caring for the young. These social bees work together to help the colony succeed. The number of bees living in a hive can vary, but a healthy and thriving honeybee hive can have anywhere from 20,000 to 80,000 bees. There are also solitary bees that live alone and do not form colonies or live in hives. They make nests in the ground or in wood where they lay their eggs. But unlike social bees, solitary bees do not make honey or beeswax. A beehive is like a busy city, with each bee having a special job. And there are three main types of bees living together. First, there's the queen bee, who is the only bee that lays eggs and is the mother of all the bees in the hive. Her main job is to keep the hive growing by laying thousands of eggs. What makes a queen bee different is she eats a special food called royal jelly, which helps her grow bigger and become the queen. Then there are the worker bees, who are all female and do most of the work, like collecting nectar, making honey, building the hive, and taking care of the baby bees. Lastly, we have the drones. These are the male bees whose main job is to mate with the queen. So, in the hive, everyone has a role to play to keep things running smoothly. No matter what kind of bee, they all start out as a tiny egg, and they each get their own cell in the honeycomb. It takes about 21 days for a bee to grow from an egg to a fully mature bee, going through an incredible transformation process called metamorphosis. During metamorphosis, they go through several stages: egg, larva, pupa, and finally into adult bees, ready to take on their roles in the hive. And while there are around 20,000 different kinds of bees, each with unique traits, let's highlight a few bees we can recognize. The honeybee is known for making honey. The larger, fuzzier bumblebee is excellent at pollination. The big carpenter bee drills into wood to nest. And then there's the striking blue orchard bee, which is smaller and known for having a brilliant blue color. But don't be fooled just because you hear that familiar bzzz. Not all buzzing insects are bees. Take wasps, for example. They're not fuzzy like bees and don't have pollen baskets because they don't collect pollen. These differences are good clues to tell them apart from our friendly bee neighbors. Today, we've buzzed through the fascinating world of bees, discovering how these incredible insects pollinate plants, make honey and beeswax, and live in amazingly organized hives. We learned that bees come in all shapes and sizes, and even spotted the differences between bees and their lookalike, the wasp. Bees are very important to our ecosystem, helping fruits, flowers, and other plants to grow. Without bees, our world would be a very different place. So the next time you see a bee buzzing around, remember how important they are to keeping our planet healthy and vibrant. Now it's time to watch another great video from Socratica Kids. You get to pick. And don't forget to check out our coloring pages and activity sheets made just for you, linked below. Did you know that these videos are made possible by our donors? The Socratica Foundation is committed to making free educational resources for kids. Donate today.